Hello guys, Croft is here. Most of you probably know that Prometheus had lots of additional footage that was not included in the final version of the movie that we've seen in theaters. The large portion of the removed footage was alternative scenes, which are extended versions of the sequences in the final cut. To me, these alternative scenes have the most interesting and intriguing moments in the film, and it's a bit of a shame that they're not in the final version of the movie. So in this video, I'll cover all of the alternative scenes, which are mostly about engineers, including the extended opening scene, Shaw versus engineer fight, which is originally much longer, and the extended engineer dialogue scene. I'll also cover other extended and deleted sequences, including Green Crystal, fiefild mutations, which are more xenomorph looking in the alternative version, and a few other sequences with Shaw. You can find these scenes in the extra material in the Blu-ray edition of Prometheus, along with some other marketing footage. Let's start with the opening scene. There's a group of engineers that approach the waterfall, and the Elder One gives the urn to the sacrificed engineer. From the early draft script of Prometheus, we know that this is the blood of the first dacon that was used to create life on other planets. One interesting clue in that scene is that if we look across the engineer's shoulder on the cliffs to the other side of the waterfall, we can actually see small figures of other engineers. These are not trees nor rock formations, because when the mothership leaves, they disappear. This extended scene gives more meaning to the creation of life on Earth and engineer mythology. We learned that the engineer sacrifice was an extremely important ritual, to the point that he was literally surrounded by other engineers who wanted to witness his sacrifice. Unfortunately, we didn't get that in the final cut. At the beginning, there is a short scene in which David is crying at what we think is the movie Lawrence of Arabia. Another pretty known deleted scene is Yannick with a Christmas tree, which is another reference to Jesus, and there's even a small figure of Jesus as a decoration. Then later in the same room, Shaw celebrates the fact that humans are not alone in the universe, since they discovered the engineer head. But Charlie argues with her, saying that we're still alone because all of the engineers are dead. Another interesting detail is the green crystal, which I already mentioned in my other video. In fact, this alternative scene is not included in the Blu-ray, and we only know about it from the early trailers. Originally, instead of the green crystal, there was supposed to be an urn, the same one that we've seen in the opening scene. Here's the exact same shot of Charlie Holloway from the trailer, but instead of the green crystal, he's looking at the sacrifice container. It's a bit of a disappointment, because I was intrigued by the green crystal and I thought it had a certain purpose for the engineers. Now let's talk about the fiefild fight. All the action in the alternative scene is pretty much the same as in the final cut, except that fiefild mutations look very different. And we can see that his head is starting to take the form of the xenomorph head. His hands are much longer and have more bones, his nose is almost gone, and the face has a very small mouth, so he was pretty much in the process of mutating into a xenomorph type creature. I have no idea why they decided to change fiefild's look. To me, he was more intimidating while looking like a xenomorph. Generally speaking, there are multiple reasons why Ridley Scott shortened all of the engineer's scenes. It was a new concept, and he probably didn't know how the audiences would react to it. Another reason why many scenes are really short in the final cut is because the movie had to keep a certain pace. Three long scenes that were shortened are fiefild fight, engineer dialogue, and engineer vs. Shaw fight. They all happen in the third act of the film, so I think Ridley made them shorter to keep a fast pace in the third act. In another deleted scene, Shaw is praying before coming with Wayland and David to meet the last engineer. Then there's an extended version of the engineer dialogue, and I made an entire video explaining this scene in much more details, so you can go check it out. But in short, here's what happened. Wayland speaks to the engineer, and David is able to translate it. Wayland asks for more life, and the engineer says, "What have you done to deserve more life?" To which Wayland responds by giving a small monologue about his journey as a visionary tech billionaire, emphasizing the fact that he created David from nothing, just like engineers created humans. Basically comparing himself to a god and saying that gods never die. David did not translate Wayland's words, but it seems that the engineer somehow understood them, and as you probably guessed, he didn't like the fact that Wayland compared himself to gods, and we all know what happened next. After the juggernaut has crashed, there is a footage of the engineer picking himself up and heading out to find Shaw. Finally, the next interesting scene is the fight between him and Elizabeth Shaw in the escape module. I think it was not included in the final cut because Ridley thought Shaw would not be strong enough to stand 1-on-1 with the engineer, so the sequence would seem unrealistic. However, this scene is really cool, and it starts with Shaw entering the emergency module and drinking something from a bar. Then she takes an axe and goes to the room with the medical pod where she sees the octopus that grew to the size of the entire room. After, David warns her that the engineer is coming for her, and Shaw hides behind the bar table. Then the engineer comes into the room with books on the floor and a broken ceiling lamp. He explores the room and sees a girl playing the violin on the screen. He looks interested and tries to imitate the hand movement of the girl. It's a nice Easter egg which hints once again that for some reason music was really important for the engineers to the point that they had to play a flute to activate their ships. Most of us have seen this photo of the engineer discovering the books scattered across the floor and pausing to look over one. Although this scene was filmed, but the footage is absent from the deleted scenes included in the Blu-ray release. While the engineer is looking at the screen, David says something to Shaw over the transmitter, which reveals her position to the engineer. After a brief moment of looking at each other, Shaw runs away, and the engineer tries to grab her. While fighting, Shaw hits the engineer pretty badly multiple times with an axe. It might seem unrealistic that she succeeded to hurt him, but I think the reason she was able to do it is because the engineer underestimated her after he killed other crew members so easily. However, the engineer also punches Dr. Shaw and throws her across the room. Then Shaw runs away to the medical pod and the engineer grabs her by the head. I think the engineer wanted to crush or tear away her head just like he did to David. Fortunately, at this point Shaw releases the trilobite, which kills the engineer. In my opinion, the extended engineer fight scene makes Elizabeth's character even more interesting and special, because it illustrates once again that she's an extremely brave and strong-willed person. It makes the arc of her character even better. If we look at the history of Elizabeth Shaw, she had many tragedies in her life. Death of her parents at a young age, inability to have children, and in the movie itself she loses Charlie and almost gets killed by the trilobite. But despite all that, she had the will to survive and move forward. Even after the biggest disappointment in her life, which is realizing the fact that the engineers hated humanity and wanted to destroy it, Shaw was still able to find faith and continue her journey. So the fact that she could stand in a fight with the engineer once again illustrates her strong personality and high sense of self-preservation. Having said all that, it was really disappointing that she died even before the events in Alien Covenant. So these are all alternative or extended scenes that we unfortunately did not see in the final cut of the movie, and most of them have engineers, which is the most exciting part of Prometheus to me. Let me know what you guys think, which sequences they should have left in the final cut, and which version of the fiefild mutations you prefer. Also, like the video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to the channel for more alien and predator content. My name is Croft, and I'll see you in the next video.